Hellmann was built off a global freight forwarding company, family owned, over 100 years old. Globally, we're 15,000 plus employees. I think we're in 134 different countries. Hellmann Wireless right now is dedicated primarily to, you know, using handheld scanner guns in order to scan product in and out of the warehouses and in and out of different shipment facilities. Our current network infrastructure is a mix of AT&T, Internet T1s, and Verizon Internet T1s, along with MPLS. Currently, we have a full-blown MPLS migration project for the U.S. and we're trying to do the same with the rest of the region, Brazil, Argentina, Canada, everybody. We don't have the resources to be able to do these things on our own, so we have to go outside and we have to find somebody to do this for us. And site surveys, as everyone knows, it is a quite expensive little proposition to get other people to do for you.
At each location, you would actually have to find a vendor there who is able to do a site survey. We were faced with issue where site surveys were done, access points were installed based on the site survey, but yet we still had signal strength problem.
The old wireless infrastructure at the warehouses has always been Intermec. It was a combination of the scanner guns, the wireless layer 2 solution. Actually, Garvin and myself constantly troubleshooting, constantly fighting through with it. I supported a very large Cisco infrastructure as far as wireless and constant problems. I was never able to truly get things to work the way I've seen it work with Meru. I really didn't feel the need to do a competitive analysis. One, their solution, as far as technology-wise, no one else really competes with it. No one else can do the same things that they can do with Virtual Cell.
With Meru, you don't need to worry about channel planning, so therefore, a non-technical person can assist with the implementation. You can have the access point drop ship at that location. At that location, as long as there is a cable connection to a PoE switch, you can actually have someone who don't have to be technical at all connect it to the PoE switch, and you can configure it from a remote location.
Made life much easier. When a new branch comes in and we got to set up a wireless deployment, hey, how big is the facility? All right, that'll take 2 or 3 APs. You know, it's pretty easy to come up with the numbers on that. We order them, we ship them out, and we're pretty much done. They talk back to the central point. My team is able to set them up within a matter of 5-10 minutes, and we can walk away from the solution at that point knowing that there's not going to be any issues. We have Meru in Costa Rica talking back to a controller here over a T1. Not a single problem. I went to Costa Rica, I was there on wireless for 4 days, no issues, works great.
With Meru, manageability has improved tremendously simply because of the controller. With the controller now being a part of the wireless network, on the security side, we were actually able to set the security up basically from the controller. From the controller is the brain. You can do everything you need to do from that access point, either local or in a remote location. In the past, we were setting the security via access point.
We use Leap authentication, tied back to a radio server, everything. I mean, you really can't ask for more. We put standard security measures on there, and no issues with it so far. We've put it in and we really haven't touched it since. There's been no issues as far as our ability to manage it, because we really haven't had to do anything once we deployed. It just works. Solution works.